AI isn't just a chat interface that you use for writing emails or answering questions. It can actually do work for you without needing you. Hi, I'm Kevin, and in this video, we'll learn how to use Zapier Agents. With agents, you can give an AI access to your apps, your data, and your workflows so it can take action, not just give advice. Let's dive in. Before we get started, you might be wondering, what's the difference between a regular AI chatbot and an agent? A basic AI like ChatGPT is great at answering questions and giving advice. It can explain things, brainstorm ideas, even write you a letter. But it stops there. It can't actually go into your apps and do the work. An agent, on the other hand, is like an AI, but with hands. You still give it instructions, but now it's connected to your tools, your email, spreadsheets, CRM, whatever you use. It can follow multi-step instructions, pull in real data, and take real actions all on its own. And that's the magic of Zapier agents. They don't just think, they act. And today, I'll show you how to build one entirely from scratch. To get started, head to the following website. You'll find a link right here at the bottom of the screen. On this page, click on the sign up button in the top right. Then run through the setup process and I'll see you on the other side. Once you're logged in, you'll land on the Zapier dashboard where you could explore things like Zaps, tables, interfaces, and more. Even on the free plan, you can start building and testing agents right away. To find agents, move your mouse over to the left-hand side of navigation. When you do that, it'll expand. Right down here, you'll see the option for agents. Right next to that, we have a large beta tag. Let's click on that to open up the agent dashboard. The first time you open agents, you'll land on this welcome screen. If you're brand new, you can click on Take a Tour. This will give you a quick walkthrough of the main features. Over here, I'll click through the entire tour. Now we're in the new agent setup. On the left, you'll see a bunch of ready-made templates for common tasks. Things like following up on sales leads, summarizing expenses, or analyzing sentiment. When you click on a template, you'll get a detailed view on the right that explains exactly how it works, step by step. You can see what the agent will do, what triggers it, and even which apps it will connect to. If you like what you see, just click Use this template down at the bottom, and Zapier will load it into the builder so you could tweak it for your needs. These are great if you want to get started quickly without building from scratch. For this tutorial, though, we're going to create a custom agent. So in the top left-hand corner, let's click on Create a Custom Agent. On the right is where you tell the agent exactly what you want it to do. Zapier gives you an example in gray text, but this is where you'll type in your own instructions in plain English. Think of it like giving a super capable assistant step-by-step directions, except this assistant never takes lunch breaks or forgets what you told it. I'm going to build an agent that checks our invoices spreadsheet in Google Sheets every morning for my favorite company, the Kevin Cookie Company, finds any that are overdue, and automatically emails customers a friendly payment reminder, then updates the spreadsheet to show it was sent. This is something I do manually today, which, as you can imagine, is about as fun as watching cookie dough rise. So letting an agent handle that, well, that's my kind of automation. Once you've described the task clearly, down at the very bottom, click on Create Agent. Now, this gets our new digital employee ready to work. Here, we connect the first app our agents will use. Right up here, click on the settings gear, and then you can connect a new account. Now, I've already connected my Gmail account that I'm going to use to send those payment reminders. You only need to add one app right now. Once the agent's created, you can connect additional apps. Down in the bottom right, let's click on Create. And look at that, we've now created a Zapier agent. Not too bad so far, but we still have some work to do before it's ready to go. Up at the top, we can give our agent a name. Currently, it's called the Overdue Invoice Reminder Sender. That default seems clear enough to me, so I'll leave it as is. You could simply click on this and you could type in something new if you prefer a different name. Now, right down below, we see what's called the trigger. And this is what gets your agent to start working. Now, currently mine says schedule by Zapier, run every day, but I need to specifically define when I want it to run. So over on the right-hand side, let's click on the settings gear. Right here, we have a dropdown where we could select the time of day. Let's go down and then find 8 a.m. right there. I'll select that. Now, the beautiful thing is the agent will automatically check for overdue invoices without me needing to start it manually every single day. That is so cool. Right over here, I'll click on save. Below the trigger, you'll notice that there's an option to add tools. In Zapier Agents, tools are the connected apps and actions the agent can use to actually get the job done. Think of the instructions that you see right here as telling the agent what to do, and the tools as giving the agent the capabilities to do it. Let's click into add tools. In my scenario, I want the agent to be able to email the customers. Right here, there's the Gmail send email tool. We added that in the previous step. Perfect. It has the right tool to get that job done. But I also need my agent to be able to check my billing spreadsheet and to update information in that spreadsheet. That means I need to give my agent two more tools. Let's click on add tool again. Here, you can find your tool. Zapier connects to over 8,000 different apps and services. Chances are, if you have an app you would like to connect to, you'll be able to find it here. My billing spreadsheet happens to be in Google Sheets, and I see it right here, so I'll click on this option. Before we configure Google Sheets, let's have a quick look at the invoices spreadsheet that our agent will check each morning. Right over here, we have customer information. We have details of the invoice, whether it's paid or not, and even whether it's overdue. And here we also have a payment link. Now, you'll notice here at the very bottom, there's the customer, George Wilson, and he currently has an unpaid invoice that's overdue. So ideally, I want the AI agent to be able to pick out this invoice, compose an email to George, and once it sends a reminder, it'll add a date in this column, letting me know that a reminder was sent. Back within Zapier, we now need to choose the tools that we would like our agent to have access to. First off, I need it to be able to look at the spreadsheet and then identify where an invoice is past due. Here I see the option for lookup spreadsheet rows. That sounds like a good tool that our agent should have. I'll make sure to select that. Then let's go back to add tools, and we need to add one more. Let's click on add tool again, Google Sheets, and let's look if there's another tool. Down at the very bottom, we have the option for update spreadsheet rows. This way, when the agent sends that reminder to the customer, it'll update the cell, letting me know that it's sent a reminder. So I'll click on this one, and that now adds a second tool to this agent. Now, I just need to make sure that each tool is in the right spot in my instructions. Here I have the lookup spreadsheet rows tool, and over here, I'll drag it to this point in my instructions. Down below, I talk about updating the reminder sent column. Let me take this tool right here, and I'll drag it down so it sits right along that instruction. This way, everything happens in the right sequence. Without tools, the agent can think through all of the steps, but it can't actually take action in your apps. By adding the right tools, you give it the ability to reach into your data, make changes, and communicate with customers, all on its own. Over on the right-hand side, there's a test agent button. This lets us run the agent right now to make sure everything is working as expected before we turn it on for real. Let's click on this to give it a dry run. Here, you'll notice that the agent has a follow-up question for me. It says, could you please provide the name of your invoices Google Sheet? Now, in my instructions, I simply referred to it as invoices, but that's not the actual name of the sheet. So let me be a little bit more clear. I'll click into here and let me put in the actual name of the spreadsheet, invoices-KCC billing. Now that I've entered in that additional detail, let's now retest the agent. It looks like it's still having trouble finding it, so let's give it some additional details and then send that. Next, I'll give it the sheet name right down here, and let's send that. The agent has now finished its work. Let's now check to make sure that it did everything properly. If I go up to the top, it found the Google Sheet. Then it looked through and it identified all of the past due customers, and there it found our buddy George. It looks like he has an overdue invoice, and these are all the details that we saw when we looked at that spreadsheet. Here it composed an email message using all the details from the spreadsheet. This all looks great. So right down below, let's click on approve. Let's now scroll up to see what else it did. Right over here, it sent the email via Gmail. Let's have a quick look to see if I received that message. Here in my inbox, I can see that email message. That looks perfect. Back within Zapier, the agent now wants to update a cell in that row, letting me know that it sent a reminder email. This all looks good, so down below, let's click on approve. It looks like the agent now updated the spreadsheet. Let's have a quick look to make sure that it actually did that. Here within the spreadsheet, I can see that George Wilson has an unpaid invoice, and over here, I can see that Zapier sent a reminder email on August 12th. Perfect. Everything looks good. It's time to turn it on. In the top right-hand corner, we have this switch, and we could toggle it on, and that enables the agent. This way, it'll run automatically every morning at 8 a.m. Once it's live, Zapier won't ask for approvals. Your agent will look up overdue invoices, send the reminders, and log the update all on its own. If you want to see all of the agents that you've created, over on the left-hand side, click on All Agents. And this brings up a full list of every agent in your account, along with their names, statuses, and when they last ran. This is your central dashboard for managing and editing them. To see what your agent's been doing, over on the left-hand side, let's click into All Activity. The Activity tab shows you a detailed run history. Every time the agent's triggered, what steps it took, and whether anything failed. If something didn't work as expected, this is where you can pinpoint the exact step that went wrong. Here, as an example, I can see the test that I just ran. I can see that it used Google Sheets and Gmail, and it looks like the test completed successfully. That looks great. This is where you can confirm your agent is doing exactly what you expect and nothing more. You can actually start using Zapier Agents for free. On the free tier, you get access to all the agent features plus 400 activities per month. An activity is basically any action the agent takes, like looking up spreadsheet rows, sending an email, or updating a record. If you're just testing or running small workflows, that's usually plenty to get started. If you find yourself hitting that limit, Zapier has a pro plan for $50 a month, which bumps you up to 1,500 activities. And if you're running something really high volume, there's also an advanced plan with custom activity limits. This way, you can start building and experimenting with agents without paying a cent, and only upgrade when you're ready to scale things up. And that's how you can set up a Zapier agent to run your workflows automatically. Or in our case, checking for overdue invoices and sending friendly reminders. But you can adapt this for just about anything in your business. Now, you've got the essentials to start creating your own. If you found this video helpful, please give it a like, consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.